I almost got murdered on the basketball court. And basically behind a bunch of nothing, man, I found a gun to my temple, you heard me? And dude was trying to rob us, me and my homeboy. Dude had a gun to my temple saying, I'm about to blow your mother brains out and da-da-da-da-da. You about to die, you about to die. So I got my hands up like this. And I'm like, man, I never thought I would go out like this. That's what I'm telling myself. I never thought I'd go out like this. Long story short, by the grace of God, I made it out alive and I'm here. But it definitely showed me that my life could be taken in an instant like that, you know? It very well was on the verge of being taken that day, but some stuff happened. We could talk about that later. But, you know, I'm here. And it made me just want to maximize every day and be righteous. Feel me? I went to Africa when I was a teenager. I went to Ghana. Man, these kids didn't have anything, bro. Anything. Like, no electricity, no clean water, all kind of stuff that I saw that they were suffering from. Lack of material possessions. But they had joy. They had internal joy. And I remember playing on the basketball court with a bunch of the Ghanaians, the teenagers, and we shooting hoops. But they were enjoying the game way more than I was. And I was like, I'm trying to win. Like, I'm trying to post y'all up and hit three-pointers. They were just enjoying life, bro. They were just enjoying recreation. They were just enjoying freedom. And I wanted a piece of that. I didn't have that back home, you heard me? So I took that from Africa. I took that back here with me. And I was like, this motivates me to want to be righteous. Because they might not be rich, but they're righteous. There's a clear black and white line between what's right and what's wrong in life. The world get it twisted and make you think doing right is wrong and doing wrong is right. That ain't righteous. My thing is to clearly define what's right and what's wrong and to clearly choose to do right. That's it. It's that simple, bro. It's not enough to just know what's right. You actually have to actually do it every day. And you could do it today. But guess what? You still gotta wake up tomorrow and have an equal or greater desire to do it again, because temptation and any demons could come at you at any time, and they don't care if you've been righteous for the last 5 days. They'll come at you in day number 6. So every day you gotta have a commitment to being right. Temptations in the rap game that can lead me away from righteousness. Females, you know, lust, that could definitely lead you away from righteousness. You get caught up in just chasing behind whoever looks good or whoever seems like that'd just be somebody cool to lay up next to, you know what I mean? And you're chasing these physical pleasures that the world, you know, seems to put out right in front of you, you know? The desire to want to dominate or conquer something, you know, even if that's a female, like, oh, the rush of the chase, you know, that type of stuff. That's definitely a temptation in a rap game. I would say lust and greed, you know? Greed meaning I want the power. It's all about me, you know what I mean? I want the money. I want the money from all of the attention that I get. I want the fame. I want all that stuff for me to only benefit me. And maybe when I feel like it, I'll be generous and help somebody else out. You know, that greed, that lust and that greed, that's the two main temptations that come along with this rap game. And guess what? To be real with you, bro, I suffer from both of them. You know? But I'm suffered, you know, that's past tense, you feel me? Like when I smile now, it's just different, bruh, because it's like I know the mission I'm on, and I know the direction that I have been heading in, and it feels great to feel like you've overcome some demons, you know? Straight up. I think being righteous, it's not a one-time thing, so it's about who's righteous over time. I don't know how people live behind closed doors for the most part. You hear me? So I don't know. I don't want to speak on nobody else in the rap game, because that's between them and God. You feel me? A lot of people might be righteous on camera because that's part of their image, is to be righteous. man, I just reached the point where I realized why I'm in this game. And it's not to act like I'm Mr. Goody Two Shoes. It's to just be all the way transparent about who I am. And that makes me want to be more righteous, because I don't want to get on camera and have tears in my eyes like I did on the Sway interview, because I'm battling with demons and I know I'm struggling and all that stuff. I don't want to keep doing that. I want to get on camera and just be able to smile and people know, like, homie got his life together, for real. And that's motivating and inspiring me. That's one thing about D1. I want him to know, whatever I'm going through, however I'm feeling, y'all gonna get that, man. Y'all gonna get that raw and uncut, you hear me?
So when you see D1, you probably thinking the dude that's on the BET Awards, the dude that just signed with RCA Records, the dude that makes those songs that you love and they can spit with the best of them in the game, the dude who goes on nationwide tours. But at the core of that, you can take all that away from me. And I'm still a man of God. I'm still a proud New Orleanian who rep the Big Easy everywhere I go. That 504. Everywhere I go, I teach them that New Orleans is about way more than just murder and Mardi Gras. It's about way more than that. And when they see it and they see my lifestyle, see, I should have never wrote a speech. Because when I come from the heart, I should have listened to you. I love Man Landry because he grabbed my hand and said, man, just speak from the heart. And you know what? That's one thing I want all of y'all to know about life. If you do it from the heart, it's almost like it don't matter what you say, because the people gonna feel it, because they feel the passion.
All right.
And that's how I feel right now at this point in my life.